Hello, let me hope you had a fruitful day. My name is Marie and welcome to Health Facts on UBCTV Inspiring Uganda. This show airs every Tuesday at 8:30 p.m. And if you miss it, you can catch the repeats every Wednesday at 11:30 a.m. Now tonight, we are going to talk about the C-section, or what is known as a caesarean delivery. Now 30% of women lately are opting for caesarean section, and then it keeps me wondering, why not natural? Really, is it really hard? And then we want to know, what are the risks involved in this caesarean section? Who recommends for this? Is it the is it the pregnant mother? Is it the husband? Is it the doctor? Who recommends for this? I'm not alone on the show. I have Dr. Kimton from Kampala Independent Hospital, who is here to give us the insight or the details of C-section. So get a pen and a paper, write what we're going to discuss, because you might need them one day. And also you can go on our Facebook page, join the chat. We've posted this, so you can join the chat, you can contribute, you can ask, or even share your experience with us. Stay tuned. Just as I had said, I'm being joined by Dr. Opio from Kampala Independent Hospital, and he's here to give us the insight of caesarean section. Welcome to the show, Dr. Opio.
Thank you very much, Mary. I'm by the name of Dr. Opio Kimton. And tonight I'm going to be with you in this show. Thank you.
So 30% of women lately are opting for C-section. And I'm wondering, why is it, do they really want this? And anyway, most viewers out there might be not aware of what C-section is. Please explain to them what it is.
Okay, caesarean section, or commonly referred to as C-section, is a major surgery aimed at delivering the baby through the abdominal wall by cutting through the lower part of the tummy, then cutting through the uterus, and then the baby is delivered. So that is what a caesarean section is precisely. Yes. However, the rate of caesarean section of late is increasing. Yes, worldwide it is about 30%, like you would say. However, in Uganda here it's still low. Mlago is about 23%, and other private hospitals around Kampala is a little higher, but it's a little very low in other rural health facilities. Yes. Average about Uganda is about 3.1-3.2%. This is literature which is sometime back, very recent one. I'm not very sure about it.
C-section involves making a cut on a woman's womb, or what they call a stomach, and I believe it's not really an easy thing. So why would women opt for that painful thing?
Caesarean section, the indication, I think that's what we call indication. I wouldn't say they opt for, because sometimes we opt for them to do that. We will have what is called scheduled or emergency. Schedule is also called elective caesarean section. There are very many reasons why we choose elective caesarean section and why it's emergency. Looking at the scheduled caesarean section or elective caesarean section, these ones they're usually done before labor starts.
Okay.
Yes, before labor pain come, that's when we do them. And there are factors. There are factors that the baby alone in the uterus can make us do the caesarean section, or also depend on the mother's condition for us to schedule a caesarean section to be done. When you look at a baby, one of the indication is a big baby. When the baby is abnormal, it's too big, that we doctors or surgeons would think the baby cannot pass well, so that we prevent complication in that baby or complication in the mother. A big baby is one of the indications of elective caesarean section. Another one is congenital abnormalities, like when a baby has abnormality. Baby may be, yes, small. The mother may be, yes, adequate enough to push, but there will be abnormalities with it. But like if you say a baby with a hydrocephalus, very big head, here the baby cannot pass. We will always opt for caesarean section. Baby with other congenital anomalies, birth abnormalities, like any mass that has grown on the baby, they're usually common around the spinal cord in the lower back here.
Okay.
And those, and when you see them on ultrasound scan, we will always opt for caesarean section other than making the mother push the baby. Then other conditions that still make the, concerning the baby that makes us do caesar is called malpresentation. The baby is not presenting the right way that can make them pass through the birth canal properly. We have transverse lie, where the baby will lie like is across here. So the head is not down, so it cannot start being pushed. Others lie oblique lie. Some of them have poor presentation. They come with the face instead of coming with the vertex. So these ones will make us always opt for caesarean section. Nowadays even, when someone has the first pregnancy and the baby is, the legs is the one coming from down, we tend to opt for caesarean section, especially in places where there are no well-qualified gynecologists or obstetricians to deliver the baby. This condition is called a breech presentation, where the legs come first. Then the other one is multiple babies, multiple pregnancy, like twins, those ones with triplets and all that. We always opt for caesarean section to avoid complications to both the mother and the baby. However, when you look at conditions that make us do caesarean section to the, but concerning the mother this time, we have about the pelvis. When their pelvis is during antenatal visit, we assess them and we check and see that this one has an inadequate pelvis or contracted pelvis, how we say. The pelvis may be so small, which may come from any diseases like polio, any accident that could have caused fracture of the pelvis, narrowing the pelvis. So the delivery will be, we anticipate that the delivery will be difficult in this situation. So we hope to schedule them for elective caesarean section. All mothers who are very short, always when they're very short, is in a way related to the pelvic size.
Okay.
So we know that yes, the baby cannot pass through properly. So that's one. Then the others are maybe if the mother has what is called placenta previa, where the placenta is the one which is down. Placenta should be up. Placenta is the one where the baby receives blood and food and stuff like that.
Yes.
So if it's down around the cervix, we should be opening so that they deliver. Ultrasound scan can always tell us this, so we tend to schedule them, say no, you can't try, so we need to schedule you and we do caesarean section. Then others include things like uterine, maybe fibroids. When someone has fibroids down, like around the cervix, which will interfere with process of the baby through the birth canal, then they also tend to do caesarean section in such a case. And other conditions like HIV, infection, they tend to say caesarean section is better than vaginal delivery in terms of exposing the child to HIV. So it's one of the way of eliminating mother to child transmission of HIV. Then other things like vaginal warts, when there's too much warts, we don't want the baby to pass through condition of vaginal warts, which is anyway caused by viral infection. So in those situations, we always tend to choose caesarean delivery. Yes. However, caesarean section can be emergency caesarean section, which is anyway the commonest in Uganda. Yes. Emergency caesarean section, like the name suggests, it's an emergency.
It's an emergency.
So we need to do something very fast to try to prevent problems, complications of delivery, or even death of either the baby or the mother. So emergency caesarean section, when I'm to also classify it, causes by the baby, causes of indications by the mother, looking at the baby, when they have non-reassuring fetal heart, when the fetal heart, like you always listen, it's not so promising, we call it a fetal distress in most cases. the fetal heart may be higher than normal or lower than normal. Or sometimes it's so fluctuating. You find it here, then you find it here. Up, you find it so low. So some of those ones, in fetal distress, we can also do caesarean section. And still, when the fluid, the water that is draining, is green, they call it meconium stain lichen. It means the baby has been passing stool. Babies usually do that when they are in distress. So we tend to do, say, this labor is not going to progress well, we have to do caesarean section. However, a point to note, all the indications that I've mentioned in the scheduled caesarean section will become emergency when labor starts, okay? When a mother started experiencing labor pain, all those will become emergencies, okay? You understand? Yeah.
As a C-section patient, your emotions can be like a roller coaster after a C-section. The hormones are still running through your body and you may feel weepy or depressed. Some women have complicated feelings about their C-section and childbirth.
So still looking at the conditions of the baby, we may have abnormalities like, say, when labor starts, when the baby has abnormalities, when labor starts, it becomes caesarean section, okay? Yes. Then when you come to the maternal condition, that will make us, the mother's condition, that will make us do caesarean section. We still have the same condition that will make us do the elective caesarean section. When labor starts, becomes emergency. Then other things to add are things like antepartum hemorrhage, bleeding too much before labor. As long as the baby, it will make us do caesarean section. Okay. Others like what we call oligohydramnios, when the fluid, this water that always comes out, when it's too little, okay, we say baby should not be exposed to uterine contraction with very little fluid. So we tend to do caesarean section to prevent complication to the baby. Still, we can have things like inadequate contraction of uterus. Sometimes the uterus does not contract very well. Even when we augment, when we augment is when we can sometimes add some drugs to improve uterine contraction. When it's still not promising, we can opt for emergency caesarean section. Things like rupture of uterus, when a uterus maybe ruptures, will make us also hurry to do emergency caesarean section or any other signs of rupture of uterus. Then obstructed labor. Obstructed labor, I think, is one of the most common cause. When labor cannot progress, mother has a good birth canal, but labor cannot progress, the baby is not coming down, which can be because of any abnormalities in presentation. Some of them may be coming with the face, some of them may be lying oblique, so those ones will all cause obstructed labor. Or the head may not be proportional to the pelvis of the mother. So there, we will also opt for caesarean section. Things like preeclampsia, okay? Preeclampsia will always make us do caesarean section. Okay? Preeclampsia is abnormalities in high blood pressure, okay? In the mother, usually they have high blood pressure, they have swelling of the legs. When we check their urine, we find their proteins in urine, okay? Then prolonged labor, when labor has taken abnormally longer time than we expect.
Like 2 days, one day.
Or 2 days, yes. Even one day, more than 10 hours, we start thinking that this labor is really prolonged.
After a C-section, there is no time to be a superwoman. You are recovering from a major surgery as well as trying to care for a newborn. Rest as much as possible and do not do any unnecessary lifting, pulling or cleaning.
Oh, pregnant mother, expecting mothers actually who just come with anxiety, they just want to do section, they're scared of pushing. What do you do for such people? Do you really go ahead and do C-section or What do you do with them?
Many people who late, we are seeing them coming opting for caesarean section. Some of them don't want to. Some of them don't want to undergo labor because of the pain. Some of them have their own reasons. Some of them say it's easy, there's not much pain. Yes, they come, but we'll explain to them the procedure, the risk associated with it, and they can consent. If they consent, then it's done, okay?
Laughing normally feels good, but not necessary when you are post-C-section. You can be more comfortable when laughing, coughing, if you hold a pillow to your abdomen. This will help your core muscles from aching.
Yes, but it usually happens in private facilities because most government facilities people are a little so busy to do elective caesarean section. But they do anyway, because in case of any problem, they'll always complain about you not accepting their ways, the way they suggest it for themselves.
Doctor, most people say that people who are diabetic, they're at a higher risk of going for C-section. Still, I want to know how many times can one go for C-section? Is it once? Because most women say once caesarean, always caesarean. What is your opinion on that?
People with diabetes have a risk of having caesarean section because diabetes is associated with the big baby. The people who are diabetic tend to have bigger babies than people who are non-diabetics. So that's what makes them highly predisposed to caesarean section. In any case, all mothers who deliver babies more than 4 kilograms,
okay,
4 kilograms and above, they should check their blood sugar in case it's not done before surgery. And big baby will always cause about obstructed labor. Labor will not progress because the baby is big and not pass through. May bring about fetal distress during labor and all that. So to always, it has a high chance of leading to caesarean section. Then about the issue of people saying once caesarean section, always caesarean section.
Yes.
It's not true to some extent because we always, depending on the reason for the first caesarean section, but in most cases, we always give what is called trial of scar, okay? A previous scar or two previous scars, okay? If you've had 2 caesarean sections before, what we call 2 previous scars, it means someone has to undergo caesarean section. That is automatic. But always when there is 1 caesarean section and the mother does not get pregnant before 2 years, that is 24 months,
okay,
then there we can always give you time to try the scar, okay? Yes. And there are people who have had caesarean section, say in the first pregnancy, the second they delivered normally, then the third, we can always give them what? To deliver, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So the first caesarean section is always not automatic. It doesn't mean automatic caesarean section the following delivery. We'll always give trial of scar. However, if someone gets pregnant, like I say, before 24 months, and that is 2 years, that one will say what is called a fresh scar. A fresh scar is also an indication of caesarean section immediately. So when you get a fresh scar, you deliver by caesar, then you get a fresh scar, you came, we'll do caesarean, then you have 2 previous scars. They are now all the deliveries of this caesarean section.
How many deliveries, if you do caesarean the first birth events, how many is there, like maximum whereby you cannot exceed?
Okay, they'll always be considered 4 to 5.
4 to 5.
For some people 5 to 6. Okay, but we always explain to you the risk of pregnancy after many caesarean sections, because you'll be at a greater risk of having rupture of uterus. So we always advise them to stop at certain level.
It sounds silly, but many women are scared to have bowel movements after a C-section. To help make it easier, consider taking a stool softener, drink lots of water, fruit juice, and eat plenty of fruit. Gas can also be quite painful after a C-section, so avoid sodas in favor of tea.
If you just tuned in, you're watching Health Facts on UBCTV, and we are at Kampala Independent Hospital here at Ntinda Chwatwe Road, and we are talking about the C-section, and the doctor just explained when C-section is needed, what is C-section, and now we are going to know the procedure you go through or when is the procedure you go through during the C-section. Do you just get someone laid in the bed and just cut? What should the mother expect before or even after the procedure?
Caesarean section, like I had said earlier in the definition, being a major surgery, needs adequate preparation. Okay? So preparation begins when you make the diagnosis of caesarean section.
Okay.
When you make a diagnosis, we come and explain to the mother the diagnosis, and then we prepare them. Number one is obtaining consent. This should be informed consent, where the mother has understood, and then she signs. After signing, then the next of kin, usually husband, should also sign. If the husband is not there, someone else can sign. But if the mother is aware of herself and has understood, she should be the one to sign. Okay? Not anyone else to sign for her. This is obtaining informed consent. After that, then we shall do other lab investigations, laboratory investigations, to ensure that the mother, the person we are taking to the theater, qualifies to go there and will have a good outcome. The lab investigation that will include complete blood count, CBC, where we look at amount of hemoglobin, or what people usually refer to amount of blood someone has.
Okay.
Yes, but we always focus on hemoglobin, and then we focus on platelets. Platelets is one which helps in clotting, because we're going to cut someone, we need to know how much they have that can clot and stop abnormal bleeding. We also do a liver function test, kidney function test, because these are the organs that are going to be handling the drugs we're going to use. So we need to ensure that they're really working well. So we also choose drugs. If an organ is not working well, we can choose a drug which cannot work, cause toxicity to that particular organ. We also check for things like HIV.
Okay.
Yes, we check for hepatitis B to even prevent infection, not only to the baby, but even to the medical personnel who are working.
Okay.
Yes, because like if you get needlestick injury, you may get infection. Okay. Yes. Then we also do bleeding time, what is called coagulation profile, to see how much time this mother will bleed. Okay. So that if the bleeding is abnormal, then we'll anticipate. Yes, we need this. We need to prepare blood because the mother may bleed abnormally. We also do blood grouping and cross matching. We prepare blood to be there. We book blood so that in case of any abnormal bleeding that we may need blood transfusion, the blood is ready and we give to the mother. So that is a lab investigation that we'll do. Then we also put catheter, urinary catheter. This one is to empty the bladder, the urinary bladder, urine out, so that the bladder is not interfering with the surgery, and also to prevent injury to the bladder itself. Because when the bladder is too full, accidentally bladder may be cut. But if we empty, it's okay.
So that means the pregnant or expecting mother cannot eat before the surgery?
Yes, usually. Before the surgery, we don't want them to eat. Especially elective is when we tell them, please don't eat for the next how many hours.
Okay.
It depends. Yes. But if it's emergency, even if they've just eaten, it's an emergency anyway. We have to go there and take precaution. Okay?
Okay.
So the urinary catheter also helps us to see how much urine is coming out. Because if the urine is not coming out, you're giving more fluid, it means the kidney is having a problem. So it also helps us that. In case there's injury to the bladder, you also see blood in urine. So you say, okay, perhaps there must have been injury to the bladder. So let's keep this urinary catheter for a longer time in the bladder. Yes, that one will also help us in making such decisions. Still in preparation, we inform the theater team, which includes anesthetist, anesthesiologist, theater nurses and the instrument nurses to be ready, because they are all going to participate in the theater. We inform the theater. We also inform anesthetists and anesthesiologists to come and review the patient if the time is there, but if, especially in elective caesarean or scheduled caesarean section. But if it's emergency, they may not have that time, but still we'll have to call them anyway to come and see the mother before.
It is okay to go for a short walk after a C-section, and getting some fresh air can be good for you and the baby. Until you're steady on your feet, ask someone to go with you to push the stroller or carry the baby in a sling.
Tonight on the show, I had Dr. Kimton Opio from Kampala Independent Hospital, who taught us about C-section, when you should do C-section, the risks involved in C-section. Still, we had a patient who accepted to do interview with us, and she told us her experience, and she said actually that she would go for C-section. Again, well, that's all we had for you tonight. Until next time, have a good night. But don't forget to go on our Facebook page, which is Health Facts, and join the chat. You can comment, you can suggest, and I'll be glad to answer all your questions. I'm your host, Mary. Have a very good day.